On Sunday morning, it was another early start for Matt as he faced the second and last day of the final.
Didn't really sleep very well last night. Felt a little bit like Christmas. You know, when you can't sleep and you're too excited to go, I can't sleep, I'm too excited. To you,
I'm into morning, buddy.
It was the same drill as Saturday, really, on the Sunday, up early to the studio. It was just a really weird day.
Rehearsals for the big finale started. All three finalists were so close to winning the title and that life-changing recording contract. Backstage, the excitement was building.
Who's going to win? Oh! Parts with Matt, here's with one direction.
I think Matt may win because of the popularity he has, and he's a great voice.
I'll be in the audience.
I'm so nervous and so excited.
Who thinks it would be boss in the room?
It was now a three-way fight between Matt, Rebecca and One Direction.
Welcome to the X Factor Final, the results!
But first, a unique chance to sing with the mighty Take That.
Such a big deal.
After that incredible experience, Matt had to now prepare for the most important performance of his life.
Waiting to go on and sing Fireworks, I was almost as nervous as I was the first time I sang on a live show. You know, you need to justify why you're still there, even right up to the final song. So there was all that pressure that I put on myself.
I thought it was absolutely fantastic. Great choice of song.
Matt, that was a sensational vocal.
Fantastic.
First one's done. Done all I can do. I could have done it a lot better than I did. But that's how I did it on the night.
With their first performances over, One Direction were knocked out of the competition, and it was now a head-to-head between Matt and Rebecca. They were both only one step away from the title.
Getting to sing the winner song was just great. I mean, that was the first thing that crossed my mind after getting through the first stage of it. You know, after One Direction went, I was like, oh my God, we've got to sing the winner song.
'Cause when my back is turned, my bruises shine.
I just gave it everything because I had to, you know, I had to try and win.
Fuel me till the end of time. Oh, when we collide, we come together.
And it pretty much killed them, you know. I didn't fall to my knees for effect. I knew that if I wasn't in a heap on the floor, I was never going to get that last note out.
You sang that from the depth of your heart. That was absolutely amazing.
I think it was your best performance of the whole series so far.
Lines are closed and the result is in.
Matt had done everything he could. It was now up to the public to decide.
Walking out with Danny was... It seemed like every other time I was walking out with Danny, except for there was just Rebecca and Cheryl on my left. In a bit of a daze about it, you know, you're not nervous. I was adamant that Rebecca had it. So I was kind of mildly celebrating second place already.
The winner of the X Factor 2010 is...
You know, and just kind of looking at Dermot's mouth like you do every time, waiting for him to mouth the word Rebecca, and then went...
Matt!
My head was spinning and... You know, I was crying and I hugged Danny and just couldn't believe it.
Congratulations. How are you feeling?
I don't know, mate. I do not have a clue what to say.
Coming out on top was just mind-blowing. When I got to sing my winner's single again, and I kind of looked at Simon and, like, he had this look on his face of, like, right, you just won, now please sing like a winner, sing like a winner, and there's me going, you say I love you. It's you and me till the end of time. And then when everyone ran on, it was like, Saved by the Bell, and I was just like, yay, I don't have to sing anymore.
We have exclusive access.
Matt Cardle!
As Matt begins life as a superstar.
This morning I've done Daybreak, Lorraine this morning, and a Radio 1 interview, and it's not even 11 o'clock yet.
Everybody just wants to know how you're feeling, and it's amazing.